Okay, I am Florin Russo. I'm a faculty at the University of California, Merced, and today I'm going to tell you a bit about our work on terascale analytics, or specifically model calibration. And we have heard this morning that machine learning and databases seem to be kind of very separate things, right? Because models require you some specific type of coding that is very difficult to bring in the database. I mean, my opinion on this is that, well, you have to find a middle way between them, because in databases there was a lot of work that made data management quite well over the years, okay? And models, even if they require a lot of coding and complicated coding, that type of coding can actually be brought into the database to some extent, okay? And our work is exactly on something like this, okay? So specifically, if you look at a lot of the models that are out there today, I mean, you'll see that they have this specific form, okay? There is practically a function that combines data with a model, okay? And they look like complicated equations at the first sight, okay? What made these models more complicated lately is that the amount of data that you have is extremely large, right? The number of the number of examples, and at the same time, the cardinality of these models is much larger than it used to be before, okay? So now, because of all this data, we have to apply some techniques that I would say are very close to databases, okay? So I'm going to give a specific example. So all of those models are typically solved today, okay, in the training phase by what is known a gradient descent method, okay? So that's how majority of models that you can find implemented in the largest number of packages are trained, okay? So what is a gradient descent? Well, it's nothing else than an iterative method in which you start with a default model, then you combine that particular model with the data, you are gonna generate a new model, and so on and so forth until you get to find the model that best fits your data, okay? That would be the minimum part there, okay? So there are many types of gradient descent methods that are used today for training models. Probably the most important ones would be the batch gradient descent, I would say, and the stochastic gradient descent, okay? So there are little variations of the same technique, okay? In the stochastic gradient descent, you are gonna take a lot of steps for each point in the data. In the batch gradient descent, you practically go once over the data and take a single step, okay? So each of them is good in a particular area. For example, stochastic gradient descent converges much faster when you are far away from the minimum. Batch gradient descent, in theory, is known to converge much better when you are close to the minimum, okay? So even if people kind of use stochastic gradient descent largely, I would say that you should not discard the batch gradient descent idea, okay? So now, I've shown you this method, okay, which is heavily used in machine learning. Now you would say, okay, how am I gonna bring it and implement it into the databases, okay? Because databases know only SQL. Well, actually, databases have quite a few extensions that allow you to bring code from outside the database and run it close to the data, optimized right inside the server, okay? One of these extensions is user-defined aggregates, if you are familiar with, okay? So user-defined aggregate is construct that allows you to write much more complicated aggregates than count, average, whatever you are used in basic SQL, okay? So the good part about this user-defined aggregates is that if you take the problem that I showed you before, okay, training models and running gradient descent, actually that's nothing else than an aggregate problem, okay? You can write it as a group by aggregate, okay, and for a lot of models. So because of that thing, I mean, you can take the gradient descent, express it as a UDA, and then you can run it into a database, okay? So that's exactly what we have done into a system that we call GLAE that we developed for the past 5 years, okay? So we developed this system specifically for aggregate computation. Initially, we started with the simple things. Then we figured out that, hey, look, these complicated models are nothing else than complex aggregates, okay? So in addition to that, we can take advantage of research and work that has been developed in the database community, okay? So one of these is concurrent or multi-query processing, okay? So you can execute multiple queries at the same time, and this is a very important problem for hyperparameter training, okay? So that gradient descent method is actually more complicated in practice than what you have seen, because there are a lot of hyperparameters you have to train. So if you use multi-query processing, you can do that training across multiple models simultaneously. Another thing from database that you can take advantage of is online aggregation or sampling, okay? With this, you can identify those combinations of hyperparameters much faster, okay, and you can discard them. Okay, another thing that you can also borrow from the database is model parallelism in addition to data parallelism. So this is a very important problem in low rank matrix factorization, where you can avoid the unnecessary merging of models by correctly splitting the data. So if you want to find out more, read our work and come and see us at the posters, please. And you will see what is that Terra scale about.